With the update of iOS 17.4 and the release of the latest Qi2 standard, Qi2 products have been launched on the market one after another. ChargerLAB also got a 15W Qi2 wireless charger from UGREEN. Compared with Qi1, the biggest difference of Qi2 is that it can support 15W magnetic wireless charging of iPhone. Before this, except for Apple-certified MFM products, other magnetic charging products could only provide a maximum power of about 7.5 watts. However, through Qi2, Android phones can also achieve a wireless charging power of 15 watts. Next, let's do some tests to see how the UGREEN Qi2 magnetic wireless charger performs. There is a product information label on the cable. Model is W703. It can support input of 5V 3A or 9V 2.22A. The maximum output power is 15 watts. The appearance is similar to the common magnetic wireless charger. It is made of aluminum alloy and the center is laser engraved with UGREEN. The other side is covered with silicone, which feels good to the touch. The Qi2 logo is printed in the center. The length of the braided cable is about 1.5 meters. It has good workmanship and is not easy to wear and tear, which can extend its lifespan. The case of the USB-C connector is made of metal sprayed with silver metallic paint. The diameter of the wireless charging panel is about 60 millimeters. The thickness is about 11 millimeters. Compared to Apple's original MagSafe charger, it is slightly larger and thicker. It has already obtained the latest Qi2 certification from WPC and can provide 15W magnetic wireless charging for the iPhone 12 to 15 series. Of course, the premise is that the phone must be updated to the latest iOS system version. As of the time of video production, the latest version is iOS 17.5.1. Connecting the Apple 30W original charger to the UGREEN Qi2 magnetic wireless charger, the ChargerLAB Power ZKM003C shows the power is about 0.5 watts when not in use, which is negligible. It can trigger charging animation consistent with MagSafe. ChargerLAB Power ZKM003C shows the input power is above 19 watts when charging the iPhone 15 Pro Max. It is slightly higher than the 18 watts of the MagSafe charger. However, the actual charging power of both is around 15 watts. Whether it is Mini Plus or Max, it can fit with it. It can also charge AirPods usually at 5 watts. Next, we'll use it to fully charge the iPhone 15. The wireless charger and the phone will be put into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank throughout the test. Here is the charging curve made by the PC software of KM003C. The voltage is always around 9 volts. The charging curve can be divided into 4 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 19 watts for the first 8 minutes. Then the power gradually drops to 15 watts, 12 watts, and 8 watts in turn. The final part begins at 1 hour and 23 minutes, and the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 1 hour and 50 minutes to fully charge the iPhone 15. We plot it into another curve to see how fast it can be. It can charge the iPhone 15 to 50% in 38 minutes and 80% in 1 hour and 7 minutes, and it reaches 100% in 1 hour and 50 minutes. Next, let's take a look at the full charging test of the MagSafe charger and make a comparison. The voltage is also always around 9 volts. The charging curve can be divided into 3 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 12 watts for the first 1 hour and 11 minutes. Then the power drops to 7.6 watts. The final part begins at 1 hour and 37 minutes, and the power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 13 minutes to fully charge the iPhone 15. The MagSafe charger can charge the iPhone 15 to 50% in 48 minutes and 80% in 1 hour and 20 minutes, and it reaches 100% in 2 hours and 13 minutes. In comparison, the power of the UGREEN Qi2 wireless charger is slightly higher, and the speed is faster. This may be related to its better heat dissipation. After all, the UGREEN Qi2 charger is thicker, which is more conducive to heat dissipation and helps maintain high power. Then we are going to the temperature test. we recorded the highest temperature after charging the iPhone 15 for 1 hour. After 1 hour of charging, the highest temperature of the contact surface between the phone and the wireless charger is 40.6 degrees Celsius. At this time, the charging power is about 8 watts. Well, that would be all the tests for the UGREEN Qi2 magnetic wireless charger. It comes with an aluminum alloy case and a 1.5 meter long braided cable. Its charging performance is slightly better than that of the MagSafe charger, mainly reflected in higher power, faster charging, and better heat dissipation. If you have wireless charging needs, then this Qi2 certified charger is a good choice. However, Android users need to use it with a magnetic phone case. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.